outrageous. Boris hits the roof at Blackford as disrespectful accusations erupted at recent PMQ. Boris Johnson erupted at Ian Blackford for being disrespectful in his accusations levelled at the Prime Minister during a ferocious showdown at Prime Minister's Questions. In a ferocious moment, the SNP Westminster leader claimed Mr. Johnson is not fit to defend these islands before accusing him of lacking the moral authority to be leader of the country during the pandemic. The comments sparked fury in the chamber, prompting Speaker Lindsay Hoyle to intervene, demanding Mr. Blackford calm it down as Mr. Johnson urged respect from the Scotsman. Mr. Blackford slammed Mr. Johnson as being too weak to get a more cautious and sensible approach past his divided cabinet and his mutinous backbenchers in tackling the spread of the Omicron variant. He slammed, "The Prime Minister knows he does not carry the moral authority to protect the public when he has broken previous restrictions himself. The public is faced with a Prime Minister who does not have the political leadership or the authority to act to keep these islands safe." Mr. Johnson lurched back, hammering, "I think the Right Honourable Gentleman should take back what he said. I think that he should be respectful of the traditions of this House, which is you don't accuse people of things they haven't done, and it is totally untrue." It comes as earlier the SNP MP claimed the UK has the worst record of poverty and income inequality in northwestern Europe, but those claims were met with fury by Boris Johnson, who appeared to slap down the allegations. He said, "We have had the year of Tory sleaze, but now we have the year of Tory squeeze for family budgets. Economists have warned that UK living standards will worsen in 2022, but the poorest households are hit by Tory cuts, tax hikes, and soaring inflation driven by his government's policy. Under this Prime Minister, this country has the worst inequality and poverty in Northwest Europe." Mr. Blackford went on to call on Mr. Johnson to match the SNP's £20 child payment for poorer families, which he demanded should be brought in across the UK. He added, "Or will the Tories push hundreds of thousands of children into poverty as a direct result of his policies?" But Mr. Johnson held no punches as he launched straight back at Mr. Blackford for talking absolute nonsense, as he insisted the government is absolutely determined to look after the poorest in Britain. Mr. Johnson claimed that has been a pledge repeated throughout the pandemic before going on to tear apart Mr. Blackford's claims as just wrong, as he said the SNP MP had got his facts wrong. He claimed, "His fundamental point is just wrong, he is just wrong. If you look at the statistics in the country, economic inequality is down, income inequality is down, poverty is down." He slammed, "I tell you why, because we get people into work. We get people into jobs. Before the coronavirus pandemic, more than 1 in 5 people in the UK lived in poverty, according to the Joseph Rowntree Foundation UK Poverty Report for 2020-21. According to Quaker Social Action, the coronavirus pandemic is having a significant and unequal impact on people's finances, with a sharp increase in claims for universal credit in April 2020. A record 2.5 million emergency food parcels were given to people in crisis by the Trussell Trust between April 2020 and March 2021. Greg Clark, the Tory MP, suggests that NHS workers should get a fourth COVID jab so they do not get infected and can stay at work to ease pressure on the health service. Boris Johnson says the JCVI are keeping fourth jabs under review. The SNP's Ian Blackford accuses Boris Johnson of a reckless gamble which risks lives and risks the NHS, asserting that it means avoidable deaths and long COVID. "The correct approach would be more caution to slow transmission," he suggests, referring to restrictions in Scotland and the other devolved nations. Mr. Johnson encourages Mr. Blackford to take back what he said and accuses him of totally untrue comments, as the Speaker intervenes to encourage Mr. Blackford to calm down and start the new year as we mean to go on.